Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and Android 11 made a surprise debut yesterday with Android 11 Developer Preview 1. Now this is a very early preview version, and Google actually recommends that you don't install it. So it says if you're not a developer but you want to try Android 11, please wait a little bit longer. We're expecting to open Android beta enrollments in the next several weeks. So this particular update has to be installed using a computer, either sideloading it or installing it using fastboot, installing the things like baseband one by one. So I would hold off if you want to try this out unless you have an extra device. Now this is only available for Pixel 2, 2 XL, 3, 3XL, 3A, 3A XL, 4, and 4 XL. No other devices supported at this time, but they will be later on. Now the nice thing about Android is we know the actual release timeline, so we know that it's going to come out in Q3 of 2020. So here is the entire layout of when we should see those releases. They don't give an exact date, but it gives us an idea of when to expect the next one. Now this particular version, you'll see here, it says Android R or RPP1.200123.016. That's the actual build number. And this has quite a few little tweaks and changes. Expect bigger changes though later on with Google I/O. So let's go over some of the changes. Now, one of the first ones I'm actually not seeing, and up here where we have all of our different quick settings, unfortunately, I don't have this one, but there's a screen recorder built in. For a lot of Pixel 4 and 4 XL devices, it's not showing, but for other devices it is. So I'm not sure why it's not here. It's not showing up, but it's just not there. Hopefully it will be there in the future. Now, one thing that they've updated is you'll see I have Pixel Buds connected. So I have these connected right now. And if I turn on airplane mode, it will leave the Pixel Buds connected. So if you're on a plane and you want to listen to your music via Bluetooth, it will still do that. So that's a new little change that was not there before. So if we turn that back on, it will just reconnect everything else. Now, another thing they're making a change to that's in the notes, and I'll show you more physical changes in just a moment, is the hot seat down here with your different icons. There's some information in the notes that say, or in the code that say that this may change based on what you use most in the future. So this may be rearranging itself later on or have the option to do so. Right now, you can't do that. Now, a change they've made is conversations have a dedicated space in your notification drawer. So let me show you what I mean. If I text myself, it'll take just a moment to pop through here. There we go. It says hi. You'll see it also shows a bubble. I'll show you that in just a moment. But we have a dedicated conversation space here at the top. And this will allow us to use it as a bubble now as well if we turn on notification bubbles. Now, we saw this a little bit earlier with Android 10, but it didn't really show up the way you would think. And right now it's showing as a conversation that's dedicated. And then if you long press on this, you can turn on bubbles or turn off bubbles, but you actually have to turn the bubbles on within the developer options. So if you're looking for that, it's there. And the way that looks is here is a conversation bubble. So it will pop up similar to what Facebook does with Messenger. You can move it around. If I tap on it, it opens the conversation. Tells us a little more information here, and then we can drag it off the screen if we want, or we can just swipe up home and it sticks to the side. So again, it has these nice little animations. And if we tap on this and then swipe off the side, it's kind of neat that it just pops back and forth like that. So it's just one of those little updates. You don't have to use it, but it's there if you'd like to. Also from messages in the notifications, you can send images as well. So if I say hello again, and it pops in. We'll wait for it here just a moment. We can reply, and within here, we can put an image if we'd like to, or we can reply with something else depending on what we'd like to do. So in future versions, we'll have more controls, but right now, some of the things work great, some of them don't. Now, one of the things I thought was pretty interesting is frame rates. So if we go into our developer options here, so in the developer options, there's actually frame rate. So let's scroll down and I'll find it here. I'm not exactly sure where they put it. And there we go. It's show refresh rate. If I turn this on, you'll see the refresh rate in the upper left at all times, telling us what the frame rate of the display is, or the refresh rate of the display. So if I go into things like camera, it switches to 60. If I go back home, it will switch to 90. So you get the idea at which rate the screen is actually running at. It's just a little developer option I thought was nice. Now there's some new gestures that pertain specifically to Pixel 4 and 4 XL, and they have to do with music. So if we go into music and I hit play on this song and I set this down here and I bring my hand closer, it will pause the song, as you can see down here. If I bring it back again, it will play the song. And then swiping through songs seems to work even better now. So we can just go through them pretty quickly or go back the other way. And it seems to work really well now. And they've just updated this to be more responsive in general. Now in the share menu, maybe you want to share a photo or maybe share a website. They've updated your share menu options. So here, maybe I want to share this web page. We'll go to share and it pops up. And you'll see down here, if I scroll up, you'll see I have different applications. I can now pin up to 4 different ones right here. So maybe I want to pin Imgur, for example. I tap and hold, tap pin, and it shows up here. So now it's allowing you to pin 4 of them that you like, that you use most often, and then it gives you suggestions as well. Now, if we go into the settings again and we search for share or battery share, there's an option for that now, or at least a little blurb about it. So we'll go to share and you'll see there's battery share. So if I go to battery share, it says your phone's battery will run out faster when using battery share. Battery share will work with compatible earbuds, watches, phones, and more. So now it's built into Android to do the reverse sharing, but the phone has to be equipped with that. So if you want to share using this with, say, future Pixel Buds with maybe a Pixel 5 or whatever they do in the future, you'll have that option. There's also a new option for touch sensitivity. So if you use screen protectors, it should help you with that. So if we go to display, advanced, and at the bottom you have increased touch sensitivity, improves touch when using screen protectors. So this is just a new feature that's there. And if you use a screen protector, it could help if you're having issues with touch sensitivity. Now they've updated the accessibility menu a little bit. So if we go into accessibility, we can scroll down. You'll see it's changed a little bit. We'll just keep going. And down by sound amplifier or below that, we have real-time text. Now there's nothing here yet, but in the future we could have an RTT option, and it's just something they've added, but there's nothing there. Now, for those of you saying, why are you using the light theme? Well, Google has updated this with Android as well. So if we go into, say, display, and then we go to dark theme and we turn on dark theme, we can tap on dark theme and now we can change it to turn off until sunset or turn on and off based on time of day. So we've seen this before, but it's a nice little option to use so you can switch back and forth. So I tend to have that set so I can turn it off until sunset. And now it's on the light theme until sunset. So it's just something that's really nice, a little added extra that's there. Now also there's a nice option for when you're using the camera. And when you get notifications and it shakes the phone or it pops in, you can now stop that. And that's actually found under your settings as well, under Do Not Disturb settings. So let's go to that. If you're looking for it, you just go to Do Not Disturb Access, then you go to Camera and you turn off Allow Do Not Disturb or turn it on or off. So depending on whether or not you have Do Not Disturb turned on, gives you access to the camera, and you can go in here and change the permissions. And speaking of permissions, there's new permissions when it comes to individual applications. So similar to what they have in iOS, where you can only allow the application to use your location once, you can now do that with this particular update. Now, if we go into an application such as Maps, and I've changed the settings a little bit so you can see this, and try and locate myself, you can see that we now have the option for only this time, as far as allowing location information to be used on your phone. So not only do we have while using app, or deny, we have only this time. So it's a nice little addition and some added levels of security and privacy. Now there's some updates that you can't physically see that we'll see in the future with different devices. For example, better support for 5G. So if you have 5G, it will know more about the amount of data that you have available and things like that. There will also be more updates for support of displays with hole punches or foldable displays, such as the Galaxy Z Flip or those sorts of things. So it will have better display compatibility with those devices. devices in the future. There's also updates to security and privacy, such as scoped storage, for example, which sort of sandboxes apps, similar to what iOS does, but does it a little bit differently, sort of disallowing apps to interact with one another, but that can also be changed as well. So you have a little bit more granular access to that. And then in addition to that, we also have more biometric updates for about 3 levels of security. So you can have different levels of permission based on what you're doing and whether you're using fingerprint or face identification and things like that. Now, there's other things in the background we can't see as well, such as call screening improvements for stir, shake, and verification, so we should get less spam calls. There's also scrolling screenshots coming, so if you take a screenshot, you'll have the ability to actually capture more than just this, but you can have a scrolling screenshot that's not fully working. Some people have actually found it, but it's not fully working yet. There's also Wi-Fi and Bluetooth enhancements. So for those of you having issues with the Bluetooth in general, the Bluetooth stack has been improved. Then there's also new machine learning controls and low media encoding latency. So there's all sorts of little things that they've tweaked in the background. And again, this is an early preview and not really meant for day-to-day devices. So I'll probably be reverting it back on my Pixel 4 XL to the public version just because I use this regularly. But if you have an extra device, maybe a Pixel 3A XL or something, and want to try it out, go ahead and do that. The only problem is you won't get all the features with the Soli radar and things like that that are specific to the Pixel 4 and 4 XL. So that's it for a first look at the Android 11 developer preview. I'll be sure to do different follow-ups when the next versions come out as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.